So we have here with us Maya Zimmermann, General Manager of Today is a New Day, an NGO from Slovenia. And thank you very much, Maya, for being with us. We will be posing you some questions. And this video is recorded in the frame of the Nexus project. And the first question is, can you please tell us about yourself, your organization, and its activities? How was it created? What's the story of your organization?
Okay, firstly, thank you for having me. This is a great initiative, a great project. So as you said, my name is Maya, and I come from an organization called Today is a New Day, or the Slovenian version, Danes is a New Day. We're a Slovenian civic tech organization. We exist since 2012, and we work mostly in the area of transparency, open data, and democracy. And then we also do a lot of work on building campaigns, building digital campaigns, and we do those mostly with other NGOs or within various coalitions that we are a part of. We are a bit different from other NGOs in the respect that we employ also programmers, developers who help us develop various tools and various campaigns that we then use as a part of our campaigning or advocacy or information building initiatives. Our biggest project probably is Parlameter. Parlameter is a tool for tracking parliaments or making the work of parliaments more transparent. So far, we have already invested more than €500,000 in developing this tool, and it currently is live in Slovenia, Croatia, and Bosnia, and basically is used to make the work of MPs and their decisions more accessible and more understandable to the public. Consul is a software for citizen participation. It was developed by municipality of Madrid, and it was used firstly there to encourage participation of their citizen at various levels. So Consul actually has many features which are developed so to enable citizen participation. So for example, through Consul, citizens can give their proposals. Citizens can participate in various polls that they or the municipality sets up. Citizens can report problems. Then one of the modules of Consul is also participatory budgeting. And then another module of Consul is also the possibility that citizens give direct feedback on legislation that is currently discussed in municipal councils. So Consul really is indeed a full spectrum tool to encourage citizen participation on various levels of decision making in a municipality. We at our organization have decided to use Consul as a tool to encourage and to enable participation at participatory budgeting. One of the trends we've seen in the last year in Slovenia is the rise of participatory budgeting, where municipalities decide to allocate part of their funding for citizens to decide how that funding or how that budget will be used through suggesting projects and through voting on those projects. And so as we've seen that this is happening, and as we've seen the trend of more and more municipalities picking up, we've also noticed that there's a lack of a digital component to participatory budgeting, that it's mostly happening analog offline. So we decided let's try to find a digital alternative or a digital version where we could have a participatory budgeting at the same time also online and offline. The important part about Consul is that it's an open source software. which means that anyone that wants to use it can use it for free. So you go, you take their code, and you can adapt it to your case study. And this is what we've done. We have decided to use the code of Consul to apply it specifically to the case of participatory budgeting in Slovenia. When we think of digital processes, digital tools that encourage participation, we always think about how we can make this process as easy as possible for citizens. So it took us approximately 1 year just to adapt the platform. And one of the reasons why that was the case was also because, and this is on one hand, open source tools are great because they allow you to use them, to develop them, to make them better. But at the same time, with open source tools, you are tied to the code that was already developed. And specifically, Consul is developed in Ruby on Rails, which is a specific programming language that is not very often used. So that was also another challenge in terms of us finding programmers that either know Ruby on Rails or can learn and use Ruby on Rails so we can adapt the platform. So that was one aspect, just in terms of technically adapting the platform. The second aspect, which is as you said, even more challenging, is dealing with municipalities and dealing even with citizens. We talk about digital transformation, we talk about smart cities, but in Slovenia, many citizens even today don't have internet access, right? So we don't have fully covered internet network. And so we need to work within that reality that we want to be digitally advanced, we want to have this digital transformation, but at the same time, there's not even capabilities for that, but also there's a lot of fear among citizens and then also among employees at the municipalities where, as you said, so there's a lot of fear among citizens at municipalities who might themselves not be very savvy with technology or might be, as you said, concerned, why are we having this participatory process online if it's similar to elections and we always have elections on Sundays at the polling station and so on. So it's really hard to talk about impact in such a short period of time. And then secondly, we need to understand that year 2020 was very specific and unrepresentative in that respect. But maybe COVID is actually one of the aspects or one of the things that showed the need to also be developing these digital participation processes even more. So during the pandemic or during the last year, several municipalities approached us and talked to us about the fact that they already do participatory budgeting or have previously done it offline. But now because of this specific situation, they think this is actually a really good compromise and a really good way to enable participation even during such extreme times. I think very important with Consul and with any digital tool is to understand that not everyone will be able to participate digitally. So any such tool needs to enable also analog or offline participation. My first advice would be build coalitions. So if you want to introduce participatory processes in your environment, find people who are on the same page as you are. Find that one very eager beaver employee at the municipality who really likes technology or who really wants to do something innovative, but also connect with other NGOs, connect with other groups, right? So I think often we find coalitions or we find a partnership with various, maybe even unexpected groups within our environment. Equate digital participation tools with participation. Just because you have a tool for participation, that doesn't mean you will actually have a greater participation or you will actually have engagement. It's still digital tools or civic technology on its own doesn't fix democracy. It's just a tool, it's just an enabler of participation. My suggestion would be, even if you have a digital tool, do not forget about campaigning, and you do not forget about the fact that you need to spread the word, you need to educate people, and you need to basically do all these communication activities to make sure that your tool is actually used for participation.
Thank you very much, Maya. This was very informative, and thank you very much for sharing your experience and the successes of Today is a New Day. And I personally wish you more and more success and more and more participation.